Are they?
See, I win. I have a microphone. Have you ever been to Tom Chi and had a glazed donut grilled cheese sandwich? You're missing out.
Where? Yeah, like a glazed donut sliced in half, uses two pieces of bread then.
Right, they slice it, invert it, put cheese and grill it. Boom, happiness.
Are you serious?
Security? We're going to have them removed. In fact, let's just start a little prison of people who will have to go. We'll all mock them as they leave. No.
Are we writing this?
And there's only personal justice in the wasteland, so...
Well, you guys got that. I'm just... I'm the true carry, which means I don't matter.
Oh, that's okay. You still don't. Anyway. true carry, not you, good sir. You matter. You matter.
We're going to kick it off with questions only, which means you guys will get buzzed with points, minus points if you don't use a question. So we need a scenario from the audience for what these guys are going to be asking.
I need a location. Give me a location where that mic fit up on the stair. Hold on, stop! Stop! I haven't even finished what I'm asking for yet. You're just blurting crap out. Crap. Can I say crap?
Yes.
Yes, I can.
Crap is fine.
Okay. I need a location that you might imagine would fit on this stage. Go. Where? What? Cedar Point? What is that? Something I might know and be aware exists. A gas station. We're at a gas station.
No, a bookstore.
We're already there! I have the location, it is a gas station! And shh, silence.
Do you want some gas?
How much is it for a gallon?
Don't you have any money?
I am kind of... not doing it.
I need another location.
A dump bookstore.
Right here. What? Prison. We're in prison.
And he's got the banana.
Did you hear the word?
What?
Have you heard about the plan?
There is a plan?
You didn't know there was a plan?
Oh, that was a question.
That was a question. Was this guy sucks.
Minus 1 point away from you,
minus 1,000 points to me.
Those weren't questions.
And go back to the scene.
You didn't know there was a plan?
Are we breaking out of prison?
Why are you saying that so loud?
Did someone dig a hole?
Do you see any holes?
Isn't that a hole?
What is that?
All right, need another location.
That's fine.
Candy store. Right there, what?
Candy store.
Is there anything in particular I can help you look for?
Don't you guys have candy?
Doesn't it look like we have candy?
It doesn't.
Sorry, we're actors. We don't know what statements and questions are.
It doesn't?
Would you prefer jawbreakers? bears or gummy bears or sugar-free gummy bears?
Are you guys hiring?
Do you need a job?
Do I look employed?
When was the last time you worked?
What time is it now?
Why would that matter?
Is this East Lansing?
What time zone is that?
Did you used to be a homeless guy?
What have you heard?
Ask you!
That's it.
Did you hear something?
Why didn't you say bless you to the person who sneezed?
It's me, Chris. Chris? All right, give a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, good time. That's, ladies and gentlemen, how improv is done. Not that well.
That is how improv is done.
Right, if we laugh, we don't care. That's what they want. That's what feeds us. That's what gives us our inner. We're like zombies who crave laughs.
Laughs. Laughs.
Must have laughs.
Emotap.
Emotap.
If it were that easy, they'd never make a movie about it.
By the way, Tyson won that speak. It's like 11 points.
Sweet. Run number, baby.
We're going to sound effects, so we need you guys to pick someone from the audience.
Oh, I need an audience member.
I don't want to hear it.
That's me. You. What's your name? Correct. Austin, I need you on stage. Your Tyson is going to explain something to you. Okay? Alright, so what's your name?
He's not leaving, Mike. I'm going to go up there.
Alright. Austin, while Tyson's talking about Austin, basically, Austin is going to have to provide sound effects that will take place in the scene that's about to follow. So if we open a door or drop a book or pull out a trumpet, he has to make those sounds for us. As you can probably tell, they may not sound exactly what it is that we need them to sound like, so we have to justify whatever sounds do come out of Austin, all right? So what I need from you guys is give me an occasion you might celebrate that's not a birthday.
Oh. Bar mitzvah. Bar mitzvah. Bar mitzvah.
Graduation. Nah. Oh, you know what? I need some kind of activity.
Welcome to the TSA scan.
Wait, right here. What? Hang gliding. Okay, hang gliding. All right. So, Austin, you know what you have to do?
Yep.
You stand right over there. All right, so here we are, ladies and gentlemen, sound effects, hang gliding.
Chris, come on in. I want to show you this awesome setup I've got. We are finding the best way to aerodynamically test our hang gliders.
Oh, man, that's an amazing setup. You mind if I pick it up?
Do you see the on button?
Oh.
Go for it.
Okay, I'm just going to push this button.
Shoo! It didn't do that earlier.
It didn't? Okay, does that mean it's on, or did I break something?
I think we actually probably need to go and crack it open and take a look. So.
Okay, yeah, just crack it. Man, that sounded like a human skull.
That wasn't the panel. I had accidentally just ripped the top.
Wow, you're incredibly strong.
Well, I've been doing aerodynamics testing for many years now, and that, you know, puts a lot of, you know, emphasis on the core. No, listen, I'm going to flex. I'm going to... That was just my belly, dude.
That your just muscles made, just created, like, broke the sound barrier.
Yeah, that's why I have this protective layer on top. Because they are so powerful. You don't know what's gonna happen.
Well, I'm gonna pick this bad boy up. I'm gonna strap myself in. All right.
Okay, so
this
is.
Oh, I ripped my pants. Some skinny jeans.
I got some duct tape. Okay, that's as close to your butt as I'm gonna.
All right. All right. Well, let me strap these things on and.
Click. Nice.
Oh, I got one.
All right, well, that was nice.
Okay, all right, now what we're going to do, I'm going to go and get the wind tunnel started so okay. You can really simulate.
Oh, yeah, this, man, this is like, it's like a reality, virtual reality wind chamber there.
Absolutely. At one point during the fan, we're going to start letting a stream of fog go, and you're going to see it just go right over you.
Oh, so I'll be able to watch the aerodynamics
the
take place.
The aerodynamic principles are going to be in effect.
That is amazing. All
so
right.
So first, the giant fan.
Wow, I'm feeling the zone here. It's amazing.
It's great, isn't it?
All right.
You feel like you're flying and you're in a room.
What do I do? I just jump up and I just...
Yeah. No, you're going to need to... there's a special bouncy area on the ground.
Yeah.
It's going to squeak.
Yeah.
And you know that you're getting the right liftoff if you get the right pitch of squeak.
Okay, but any time before I go hang gliding, I always play a little tribute to my dad on my kazoo. I just this little song I played for him because you know he's in Detroit right now. I feel bad for him. Okay.
I'm sorry,
that was my pocket tuba. Let me get my kazoo.
Did you just play the opening to Beverly Hills 90210?
Yeah. Kazoo sounds like this. You go. I'm not sure he knows what the hell a kazoo is.
I'm going to shut the band off because forget aerodynamics, we're starting a band.
We're starting a band? You play an instrument?
Yeah, dude. I got this keytar right here.
Oh, man, I love keytars.
I'm going to break out a little jam for you.
Go for
it. It's a keyboard in the shape of a guitar. It's a guitar. That's, you know.
Right.
I just felt like saying that out loud. I don't know. So.
I think that's the kind of music we want to go to. It's like nursery rhyme.
It is an untapped market.
It is. Nursery rhyme.
Nursery rhyme.
Yeah. And C, ladies and gentlemen.
Points to Austin for his wonderful kazoo playing.
All right. See, this is going better than I thought.
And remember, gang, friends don't let friends play kazoos. Shiny.
That's what made me think of it. Kazoo. What do we got next there?
We've got Let's Make a Date, so if we can get Miss Sarah Sullivan up here.
Ooh, yeah.
Sarah Sullivan, ladies and gentlemen, give a hand.
You have to forgive me, but in terms of me and how we're going to play my own
self. I can move up.
So here's what we're going to do. Sully is a contestant on a dating game, and she is going to be going through the three bachelors and trying to figure out who they are. And I have the cards here as to who they are. She doesn't know. You've written these beforehand. And she will ask them questions individually, trying to figure out who they are.
Before we get started, I just want to do something real quick. So I need everybody to pay attention to me. And, Menomina. Thank you.
No.
All right.
Do we need a host? Welcome to the dating game.
With your host, that guy.
With your host, the narrator.
And straight into the game, ladies and gentlemen, Sarah Sullivan, our contestant, trying to pick out from three lucky bachelors to go out on a date. Sarah, why don't you ask question number one?
Question number one. What is your ideal first date location?
She walked into my life. She's beautiful, brunette. She sat in a chair, she asked me questions. I was curious.
I'd like to go somewhere where you can see everything and there's nothing hiding anywhere around there or over there. This is good, I can see all of you. Okay, yeah, that's where I would go. Any place I can see everybody.
Assuming that you're a leprechaun, you don't want someone to get your lucky charms?
I do.
Okay. All right, question number two. What is your favorite food? Is Tyson a mime?
She asked me what my favorite food was. I think she wanted to go have dinner. I took her to a nice place. We had some vino. We had good times, good talk. She's a nice lady with good gams. I like gams.
Are you Vic? Oh God, this is being filmed.
Not many people could aspire to be Vic Mignogna. I was one of them.
Okay. Sorry, I wish I had a list of questions to ask. Where do you see yourself in 5 years?
Adventure, excitement. A Jedi creates not these things.
She walked into my office 5 years too late. Where do I want to be in 5 years? In her. Oh wait, not like that.
I'd like to be in my room where no one can find me, where no one can track me down. Oh God, did you hear that?
They are watching you.
No, they're not. You're lying. Stop lying. I think you're a liar.
Okay.
All right, that's all the time we have, contestants. Sarah, would you like to take a guess at who Bachelor number one is?
Like I said, I'm lying originally, but that wasn't right.
Bachelor number one.
Oh, Silent Bob!
Oh, that is correct. Absolutely correct. Would you like to take a crack at who Bachelor was?
A movie announcer?
Oh, close. Not at all. I was a film noir detective. Oh. Right? It's pretty awesome, huh?
See,
and
I was trying to think of like a specific like character
right,
kind
right.
of thing, so that's why it really threw me off.
We deal in generalities here. No. And would you like to take a crack at who Bachelor number three was?
I have no idea.
Who were you, Bachelor number three?
A paranoid Scotsman.
That's not even the thing.
A Scotsman?
That's what.
Scotsman can be paranoid too.
I'd like to see you say that to a Scotsman.
It's too big.
That's why. Ladies and gentlemen, Sarah Sullivan, let's hear it for her. Woo! Beautiful, wonderful.
second suitor. Suitor number two sounds like something about a bathroom code.
Suitor two. Guys,
suitor two, electric boogaloo.
All right, okay. What else we got there?
Well, next up we have mannequins.
Mannequins? Oh, the arms? Oh, well, that would have
been. I had it written down on my sheet as prop arms.
Oh, okay, that's fine. All right.
It explains the game in the title.
We're going to need this table to move there.
Fail. GG.
Okay, now for this one, I need another volunteer from the audience. Someone who's relatively the same height as my friend. Yeah, I know you. Luigi.
Someone who's totally cool with having Luigi, nice sweaty armpits on your arms.
Yeah. If you don't mind being very, very close to Tyson for the next few minutes, come on up here on the stage. What's your name, sir? Other than Luigi?
David.
David. Let's hear it for David, ladies and gentlemen. David, this is a game in which you are the arms of Mr. Tyson here. Man, you're much taller than Tyson. This is a bad choice. Can you squat down just a little bit? Here, you know, I can put a chair underneath you if you need me. Anyway, not that far. Not to pull him down. No, stand back up. That's forget that.
Awesome squats right now.
Right. Stand back up, David. Stand back up. Stand back up. That's fine. Basically, you need to watch these, is what I'm saying. But that's, leave them on. I don't know. I kind of like them. So the deal is David, you are the arms of Tyson. Tyson is a Shuto Con attendee this year, and I want to interview him based on his costumes and his experience here at Shuto Con. So are we ready for that? Can someone for Tyson, do you want me to have them give you a character, a joke, or maybe the genre of character you are? I need a genre. Okay, superhero. I heard superhero. So Tyson, you are some kind of superhero.
So what you do normally.
Here we are, ladies and gentlemen.
Interview
with a Shuto Con guest attendee here. Hello, sir, how are you?
Oh, I'm doing fine, thanks.
Oh, good to have you here. We're really excited that you're here.
I'm so excited. Nice to meet you, too.
Nice to meet you, too. Just fist bump that.
Totally.
Really counted. Yeah. All right. You know, I love the costume you got here. Who are you today?
I am Wizard Valkyrie Samurai Man.
Wizard Valkyrie Samurai Man. That's amazing. Can you tell me what are some of his special powers?
Oh, dude, he can fling slinkies like nobody's business.
Oh, can I see that? I want to see something. Just kind of hear you do that little slinky. There you go. There's a slinky for you.
My coordination's not what it wants.
No, I understand. I'll help you out there. And show us how he flings a slinky.
See?
Man, that was very far. Seriously, I'm impressed.
It's a finishing move. I don't like to break out all the time, but this isn't it.
Right. Now, is this the full costume, or is there interchangeable parts to the costume? I know there's, you know, lots of different facets to wearing a cosplay.
There is a lot that goes into the cosplay. That's absolutely correct. I can count on my hands how many things there are that go into it.
Okay, go ahead.
There are 1, 3, 5 things.
Are you sure?
They interconnect.
Show me again.
They're 3, 5 things.
3, 5 things.
Between 3 and 5 things.
Okay, let's get, I mean, what's number 2 on that list?
Number 2 on that list is a healthy breakfast with a banana. It's real squishy.
Yeah.
So you know it's
good. You just eat the banana with the thing on it? This is a family convention.
Yes.
You never talk about banana or
this is still a PG panel.
Great. And I love this thing here. I mean, does this thing have special powers? Be careful now. Be careful.
Its first power is being too large for this particular environment.
Right.
Which comes in handy in innumerable ways.
I bet. Can you show me? I like how you do that.
See, I can do lots with that.
I bet you can.
There's also what looks like a bird's nest in the top of it.
Can we get a closer look at that? Okay. Ooh, thank you. I'm good. That's close enough. Okay.
Down because so much power, it's hard to handle.
Now, do you have like some kind of sword attack or something with this that you can?
Have I got a sword attack?
Yeah.
Samurai's in the name.
Oh, it is in the name. That's right. Can you show it, like maybe show us a samurai swordsman move?
This is an attack where basically you're trying to cut the opponent's head in twain.
In twain.
In twain.
In twain.
Yes.
Mark Twain.
So it goes a little something like that.
Like that.
You don't want to meet me in a dark alley, friend.
I don't know. I felt that was a little loose in the wrist there. I feel like I could just knock that out of your hand.
You have to have fluid movement.
Fluid. It's got to be fluid.
It has to be fluid.
Okay.
Because otherwise, you are just waiting to be toppled over like a wall.
Right. Right. Now, do you have, because since we're a samurai, I know that they have other protective guard and stuff. Yes. I mean, how do you protect yourself?
Well, first, I have this mighty beard.
Okay, the mighty beard. Let's get involved with your beard on your face.
Mostly the chin area.
Yes.
It helps me really, get from level 5 to level 7.
Sure.
That's done. And I only work in prime numbers as far as my levels go. That's part of the battle.
5, 7,
right, 11,
13. 13 is like, the best.
It is. It's about as high as it goes because I can't count on my hands how high it goes.
Right.
So
use your feet?
I do use my
feet. No, okay. Oh, what is this? What do we have here? Tell me about this.
This is the hat of classic battle strategy.
Yeah?
In it, I have acquired all the knowledge of Sun Tzu and the art of war. Unfortunately, it blows off at the slightest breeze.
Yeah?
And that does make for humorous situations for my character.
Does it? Let me kind of, just like that.
And then I don't have the reflexes to make it back.
You can just slingshot a slanky.
Exactly. What you do is the hat comes off, it's a big decoy, it's a distraction, then comes the slinky.
Right.
And if that doesn't do it, sword coming, baby.
Right, it's sort of like Drunken Master.
Totally. Mostly like drunk.
Oh, just no master to it.
Very little master.
It's just drunken.
It is mostly drinking.
Drunken samurai.
When all else fails, I walk home with a staff because I'm very tired.
Oh, that's great. That's great. Well, I really appreciate you being here, guys. Let's hear it for Tyson and David, ladies and gentlemen. Woo! Thank you very much, sir. Appreciate you. Make sure you put those in the laundry tomorrow. All right, I don't know what you've been touching.
Didn't have to touch me. Right. Give him a big hand.
Yes. All right. What do we got next, sir?
We're gonna go with unlikely superheroes. So what we're gonna need to yell at the audience is the name of an unlikely superhero.
And then we have to create that superhero. Flatulence man. Hold on. Let's get this set up here first.
The character is Flatulence Man. Am I starting?
I don't know.
And we need a crisis. We need a crisis for Flatulence Man. So the scene goes, and Chris is Flatulence Man, and then Tyson will come in a bit, and Chris will come up with another superhero name for him.
Da-da-da-da! Oh, almighty! My fart has broken the back of this chair. Why I sign like a pirate, I don't know. Oh, Flatulence Man has been too flatulent, and now there's nay enough toilet paper!
Did you say there's nay enough toilet paper?
Nay, I said! I did! What shall we do?
That's a good question.
I don't know. I think we should call security.
Well, that's a good idea. I like that idea. Who should I tell them is calling?
Flatulence Man!
And his sidekick,
Poop Boy!
That's right. I'll get security on the phone, Flatulence Man. You can count on Poop Boy.
Listen, they're probably going to tell you lies about me. I don't want you to listen to those lies. That was only one time. Only one time, and I had a lot of drink that night. Well, I had a lot of cheese, and a lot of cheese, and some extra cheese on top of that cheese.
Flatulence Man, I know what cheese does to you.
It does. It gives me my strength.
I remember what happened to me. Growing up, a young turd lad. One day, all the toilet paper in the world got wet and soggy. And from that day on, I was poop boy. Avenger of the toilets. Savior of sewage. I'm a scourge to something. And that's why we partnered up, Flatulence Man.
That's right. Pull my finger and let's head to the dunk cave. All right, now we're in the dunk cave.
All right. That was easy. I forgot how you also have teleportation powers when I pull your finger.
That's absolutely correct. That's what happened. Now, as you can see, in all these sectors here, they are lacking toilet paper, and people can't wipe their butts.
I think I have it. These projection screens that we're using to monitor the poop crisis could be cut into toilet paper.
It's made out of electronics, poop boy.
What's
the projection screen?
The projection screen.
Oh, yeah. Let's cut the projection screen.
Right now, how are we going to cut? Are we going double ply or single ply? Because probably single ply is the better option.
Well, the question is, how do we roll it, really? I mean, when you roll it, are you going to pull it down or from underneath? Or do you like to go over the top? Top roll.
I will hold on to it, and then you spin me.
Yes.
And then, like sushi, you cut me into slices.
This is brilliant!
And like true poop, I will reform.
I'm gonna stop right there, ladies and gentlemen. Let's hear a real round of applause. It's not a game I thought we were just gonna come up like world's worst. Anyway, that's a game we should play. We should play that one. Hey guys, in fact, we will play that one right now. Let's, what did you have next?
Well, we were gonna finish off with Scenes from a Hat. Well, no, we can just go forever with Scenes
from a Hat. Go for it. Well, I'm going to do one more game before we do Scenes from a Hat. This one's called World's Worst. And what I'm going to get from you guys is the world's worst something, and then we will recreate it for you here on stage. So the world's worst what? Yes, hold on, right here. You got what? What?
Boy band.
The world's worst boy band.
All of them?
Ooh,
girl, you know that girls are female. You got two X chromosomes, girl.
A girl.
Yeah, girl, thanks. Thanks, ladies, thanks. It's great to be here in Detroit, ladies. We are Terrible Boy Band 1, or TBB1. One love.
All right, give me another name. World's worst what? Yes.
Plumber.
World's worst plumber. As you can see, my pants are all the way up here. There's no crack. Sorry.
Yeah, that was poorly done as a plumber. Let me show you what a real plumber did. Is that a superhero in the toilet?
Give me another one. World's worst what? Yes.
Village
chef.
World's worst chef.
All right, Andrew, you're going to want to remember when dicing vegetables to not do this. Cut.
Here you go. Give me something else, another one in the back over there, yes, you.
Fangirl.
World's worst fangirl. Hi. I really like your show. You're how I first discovered I like boys. I like you. Can you hug me?
Give me another one.
Over here, yes. World's worst Disney character.
What?
Hi, I'm Pocahontas.
I can't disagree with that. Another one, give me something. What?
Four kids character.
What? Four kids character.
Why am I watching
the
four kids?
Okay, world's worst four kids character. Hi, kids. You have to stay at least 50 feet away from me.
Wasn't DBZ on four kids for a while? Wasn't it?
Yeah. I'm Mr. Bobo, and I'm Purple.
Oh, Goku!
In the back of the purple, great orange hat, yes. World's worst doctor. All right, guys, I think that just about does it. Anyone see my watch? Let's cut them open.
Now, when you're in the operating theater, we are, of course, going to have you in one of the hospital gowns that doesn't have a back. So it's going to look something like this.
World's worst what? Yes, you're right there in the middle.
Bank attendant.
Hi, welcome to Chase Bank.
This is 20, 40, 60. Let's start over. 20, 40, 3, yeah, let's take off.
Over here, yes.
World's worst pilot. Ooh, that's tough. I don't know if I want to touch that one at the moment.
I know.
It's a little touchy. Oh, hush. Quit whining. In the back with the white hair, yes. World's worst devil. Hey, that's on Mr. Satan. Thank you.
Well, you're pretty good at your fiddle, boy. Give the devil his due. I'll bet a mule against your soul I can play better than you. You need a mule? Oh, no? Okay, well, have a good day.
Man, you look like you had a lot of sinning going on. Go to heaven. You're good. Oh, no big deal.
A couple more. You, sir. Yes. Yes.
World's worst waiter.
Yeah, I've lived that one.
I've been that one. And our specials today are the Chilean sea bass and the filet mignon. Our specials today are the Chilean sea bass and the filet mignon. Sir, our specials today are the Chilean sea bass. We also have filet mignon. No, they're Chilean sea bass or filet mignon. And could I get you some Chilean sea bass or filet mignon?
Hey, what's that guy? What y'all want for eat? Huh? What? I'm just taking drinks, man, right now. You're ugly. You are. Your mother. Yes, you, sir.
Actor.
World's worst actor. Hi, I'm Chris Rager.
We love you.
Hi, I'm Ian Sinclair.
Oh, shots fired.
No.
Yes. Shots fired.
Is that a TARDIS back there? Awesome.
Oh.
Oh, look, you're going to piss off.
Do it.
Don't forget, it's a safe space. They can't actually kill you.
It's a safe space, so you can't touch it.
Just don't leave the convention center.
Oh boy. I'll go. World's worst comedian.
World's worst hentai.
The world's worst hentai not scientist comedian.
Why don't we jump into the scenes from the hat? And we'll wrap it up here for
scenes from the hat.
Scenes from hat. From hat. Hat.
Words
writ in the bathroom of the Pokemon Center on the stall walls.
If you follow a certain someone sitting on this seat, you truly will catch them all.
Sit here, and you'll get squirtled.
That's the only Pokemon I know.
Attack on Titan, kids version.
Oh. Mom, I ate my G.I. Joe!
I get it.
I have no idea. I've seen zero of that.
Hi, I'm Chris Rager. I have no idea.
Special.
Being a dorm room inspector.
Oh.
A what?
A dorm room inspector.
Dorm room inspector.
All right, guys, I'm in here. Let's go ahead and pull up all your sheets and let's go ahead and get the black light on these. Oh my God! I've been sleeping in that.
Awkward moments in an elevator with cosplayers.
You remember that episode you were in with the thing and the guy and he did the thing and it was awesome? You smell good. I like you.
Thank you.
The floor
you is my floor.
Princess Zelda waiting for Link to come save her.
Where you been? You know how long I had to wait in this place? I'm just running around with your little sword and boots and stuff. I haven't had conditioner for 3 weeks.
I would have saved myself, but my chic outfit was at the dry cleaners.
Puns that congoers make.
What?
Puns that congoers would make.
All right, earmuffs, kids. You know, I hate doing the big room shows because, you know, I always get, like, soupy Dragon Balls. That's what I said here.
Oh, hey. A groaner's as good as a laugh. Where did he come from? Puns that con members say? Man, all of them are dirty.
All right.
I can't think.
An oblivious person at an anime con.
An oblivious person at an anime con?
I don't understand why all these kids like that Star Wars so much. It just seems crazy. I don't get it.
I don't think this is the plumbing convention.
That's right over here, man. Come on this way.
Thanks, Black Shorts, man.
Arriving at a convention in a cosplay only to find out it is a black tie event. Oh.
Well, they won Sailor Moon, they're gonna get Sailor Moon.
Well, they want Freddie Mercury Titan, they're getting Freddie Mercury Titan. There's Freddie Mercury Titan.
What was that? I wasn't on that show, so I'm not aware. If I'm not on the show, it doesn't matter.
If Vegeta became the president of the United States.
Hey, we got this. That's what I was going to say then. Vegeta was the president of the United States?
And remember to vote for me, Kakarot, at Connecticut.
I demand more maple syrup, Canada.
I am the prince of the president of the United States!
Stuck as yourselves in the Hunger Games.
I'm obviously not that hungry.
Yeah, I knew it.
This one just says crab battle.
The crabs follow that every time.
Stupid crabs.
New Pokemon that kids would love.
Sugar-free Haribo, I choose you!
What time is it?
It's 1:30 right now, so if you want to do maybe a couple more?
Do a couple more, yeah. Y'all want to see a couple more?
I'm going to assume this is a panty and stocking one. It says, hiding in panties closet.
Oh. How old is everyone here?
Not old enough.
Over there.
No.
Man, next one.
There's nothing in my head that's not insanely bad. Oh, you had something. I'm sorry.
Could you just let me out already? It's dark.
Ooh, girl, I love these stockings in here. It's great. Come out to play. Okay.
Spoilers. Chris Rager is a Valley Girl.
I think this is a good one, and serenade the person next to you.
Oh, wow.
You are so beautiful to me. Can't you see?
He was looking for a soul to receive. Give a round of applause.
Give yourselves a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. It's great for you guys.
And thank you to all of our volunteers that really helped out. Thank you to Mike for being a good moderator.
One
thank
more
you,
thing. We got to decide who won.
Oh.
All right. Round of applause.
Ripley Rochambeau.
Who thinks Tyson won? All right, let's get some noise for Chris. Oh, that's pretty rousing.
How about noise for Mike?
I think the deeper voice people liked me better.
Who thinks Hat won? You guys both lose to a hat.
Oh, man.
How do you feel
that's
about that?
Time this happens here.
And it won't be the last.
It will not. Once again, thanks a lot, everyone. Enjoy the rest of the car. We got more stuff, all kinds of fun stuff happening. You guys are great. We love you. Peace, love, and happiness.
Woo!
To your mothers.
Way too long.
I really want a banana.